Hi guys, it's Jim from Tech Advisor, and today we're going to be unboxing the new Apple Watch Series 4. So here it is. This is the new 44mm silver aluminium case with the white sport band, and that is the larger of the two new watches for this year. So let's get rid of this plastic wrapping, and then we can get into it properly. Okay. So, this box has a slightly unusual design, but if we undo these tabs, we can unwrap the goodness inside. Now, we've got two boxes. One of them is for the white strap, so if I open this one up first, we can get that ready. So, as usual with Apple, we've got one strap, but with two sizes. So you've got the part that connects to the top or bottom of the watch, depending on which wrist you wear it on. And you've got the longer, medium and large strap, and the shorter, small and medium strap. We're gonna be installing the small one because the big one is actually massive. So here, we've got the watch itself. Interestingly, it's packaged in a lovely little fabric sort of pad to presumably keep it nice and safe in the box. So there we have it. If we install the strap, it's as simple as sliding it into the grooves and it aligns magnetically. And there we go. And as you can see, it's turning on. Just to give you a quick look at the watch, the main new feature is, of course, the rounded edges. So the screen has got larger, but the device itself hasn't really increased in size at all. In fact, it's very marginally thinner than before, but the 44mm screen, the larger one, actually has 32% larger screen than before. If you go for the 40mm one, then that's actually 35% bigger screen compared with the Series 3 and previous ones. So as we can see on the screen, it's telling us to bring the iPhone near to the Apple Watch. So if we grab our iPhone XS Max, if we unlock it, we should find that it will give us the option to set up a new Apple Watch. So we'll just tap continue. And then we bring the watch in front of the camera and it reads that that image on screen, which is a bit like a QR code, I suppose, but it's proprietary to Apple. And then tap set up Apple Watch. Now, because we are left-handed, we wear it on our right wrist and we're gonna choose to have the crown on the right. What happens then is that we have to agree to the terms and conditions, of course. We're not going to read them. And then it will sign into your Apple account and it will synchronize everything that's necessary between what's already on your phone and on the watch. There's a couple of other features which I can talk about while that's happening. And on the back, you'll notice that rather than having an aluminium back, this one's got a black ceramic surround. And that's important because on the cellular models, it means that you get a much better cellular signal out of the back of the watch. Previously, the cellular signal was good on an Apple Watch, but to improve that and make things more responsive and better for all things that are happening over the cellular connection, they needed to make sure that the signal could go in the front and come out the back. And it can do that with this lovely ceramic finish. There's another thing here as well. This little band round here is important because it allows it to do what's called an ECG. And this is kind of a medical thing, which let's say we're not experts in this, but it's the first time a consumer device, which is sold direct to consumers, can give you what's called an ECG. And this is where you, you wear it on your wrist and it's to do with an electrical signal. So you have a a little metal contact pad on the crown, which you have to press and hold while it's measuring the ECG. And what it will give you is one of those sort of little graphs where you get the graph of the heart rate, and that will show your doctor various things about the state of your heart and whether it's got any issues or not. Unfortunately, that's not available in the UK yet. It's not actually available in the US either until Apple pushes out a point release of iOS, which will push the special heart rate app to your iPhone. And until then, you won't actually be able to use it. So we can't actually set it up here. And there's no date yet about when that feature will come to the UK. But we are hoping that because it's been approved by the FDA in the US, that will be taken basically as a sign that it's okay to approve it in Europe. And then we should get it in the UK as well. So until then, that feature is unfortunately unavailable. Now, back to the phone. So it's asking, do we want to enable route tracking or disable it? We'll enable it. And do we want to share the watch analytics with Apple? Well, we'll do that. That's absolutely fine. Hopefully it helps Apple to make the watch even better next time around. Now, create a passcode for the watch. That's the same as before. So we'll just go ahead and create one. A 4-digit passcode rather than a 6-digit as you have to create on the phone. Now, this is the part that's talking about the heart health that we were mentioning earlier. So one of the things that the Apple Watch Series 4 can do is to notify you of low heart rates as well as a high heart rate, which it could do before. You can also set your Apple Watch up so that you can use Apple Pay with it. You just put your watch against the contactless reader. We'll set that up later. And finally, there's the emergency SOS thing, which is to do with the fall detection. So that's the other new feature of the Series 4. It has a gyroscope and accelerometer, which can measure data 8 times as fast as in the Series 3. And that allows it to detect, along with some clever algorithms, whether you've had a bad fall. And if you remain motionless after that for about 45 seconds, it starts a 15-second countdown and will then call the emergency services if you remain motionless. Now, this feature is enabled automatically if you're over 65, but if you're under 65, you have to enable it manually. And this continues to work even if you are in a workout. So if you set your Apple Watch to start a workout, this fall detection will still work during that workout. So if you're a runner and you have a fall, which is quite common for runners, then the system will continue to work then. It isn't not exclusively just when you're bumbling around doing your everyday stuff. Now, we're almost there. The watch is syncing with the phone and it looks like we've got some kind of Apple Watch basics tutorial so we can learn about how to use things like the digital crown, the buttons and things like that. So if we just tap on digital crown, you press that to essentially go home and return to the watch face. You press and hold, of course, to talk to Siri, and you can turn it to scroll through lists, and there's a nice haptic feedback now, so it feels like it's clicking around when you're using it. And actually, while we're there, there's two little slots on the side, which have always been there, but now the speaker inside is around 50% louder. So if you're going to use your Apple Watch to do phone calls, then you can do it through that speaker, which is a lot louder. Finally, we're ready to go. So the watch is all synced up. We press start. Let's try out Siri. Oh, here we go. So this is the first thing that you'll notice about your new Series 4. And that is that there's a new screen, and this has more complications than ever before. So you've got 4 in the corners and 4 in the center, so you can have quite a lot of information. And actually, in each of those complications, you'll notice that there's more information than was shown in the same sort of complications before. So as well as your heart rate, you will see, if I just put the watch on, it will stop timing out. Right. So you'll see that along with the weather, the temperature, you see a low and a high temperature, and you'll see various other things. And of course, you can customize it very easily. If you deep press on the screen, you can then tap customize and you can run through the various different complications there. So you could choose weather, you could choose the new walkie-talkie mode, that's fun. You could put the walkie-talkie mode on that side, you can just tap between the different complications and choose whatever you like there. Plus you've got the Siri face, Siri watch face, and lastly, there's a couple of others just to quickly show. One of which is the new Breathe watch face. So rather than actually having to use the Breathe app, you can have that pulsing the whole time. And there's a couple of different visualizations that you've got there. And then there's the new Elemental view, which really shows off that big screen because the effects of these animations, which are actually filmed. They're not made in CGI, these are actually filmed. And they really show off the size of that big new screen. So that's the new Apple Watch Series 4. And we hope you enjoyed this video.